Now let's look at question number 2, which is again from the year 2003. The question says, a syringe with a frictionless plunger contains water and has at its end a 100 mm long needle of 1 mm dia. So this is the plunger. Okay, this is the syringe. So in this syringe we have water like this, and this is the needle. Okay, and this plunger is pushing the water in the syringe, and that comes out through this nozzle as a jet. Okay, the internal dia of the plunger is 10 millimeters. The plunger is pushed in at a rate of 10 mm per second. So this is the velocity of the plunger. Okay, and the water comes out as a jet. Assuming ideal flow, find out the force needed to push out the water in newtons. So a very simple question based on the Bernoulli's equation. So I can assume two sections. So this is section 1-1, and let us say this is section 2-2. So if you apply the Bernoulli's equation in between these two sections, so first of all, let's assume that for syringe, the subscript we used is 1. For needle, the subscript is 2. So D of syringe, which is D1. D1 is how much? Which is equal to the internal dia of the plunger. That is 10 mm. So you have 10 millimeters, which would be 0.01 meters. Okay. What is the dia of the needle, which is 1 mm? So D2 is 1 millimeter, which is 0.001 meters. The length of the needle is L2, I would say, that is 100 mm, so which is 0.1 meters. Alright, so we're done with this. The velocity at section 1 is the rate at which the plunger is pushing the water. So I would say V1 is 10 mm per second. If in meters I have to calculate, this would be 0.01 meters per second. Okay. Now we need to find out the velocity at section 2. So again we'll apply the continuity equation. So we have the diameters. Let's keep it like that. No need to find the area. So V2 into D2 square is equal to V1 into D1 square. So your pi by 4 can be cancelled out. So your V2 would be V1 into D1 by D2 whole square. So put in the value, so you will get 0.01 into D1 is 0.01 and D2 is 0.001, and you square it. This value will come out to be 1 meter per second. So your velocity at section 2 is 1 meter per second. Now we do not know the pressures at either 1 and 2, but we can say that at section 2 we can assume that the pressure is atmospheric. So I can say P2 can be 0. Okay, so now we are just left to find out the value of P1, and let's assume the datum is also same, Z1 equal to Z2. So all you need to find out is the velocity heads. Okay, so you will have P1 by rho g is equal to V2 square minus V1 square by 2g. Alright, so I can strike off this g, and P1 will be equal to 1000, that's the velocity, that's the density of water, because we are talking about water only. Okay, V2 is 1 and V1 is 0.01. square, and this is entirely divided by 2. So when you solve this part, the pressure will be in pascals, so which is 495 pascals. So this is the pressure at section 1. So if you have the pressure at section 1, you can find out the pressure force, and that is the force which is needed to push out the water in the through the needle. So you will have F into, or I would say F equal to pressure 1 into area. So your P1 is 499.95 into area 1. This would be pi upon 4 into D1 is 0.01 whole square. This comes out to be almost 0.04 newtons. So this corresponds to option number B, which is correct. So again, a very simple question. Look at it as a setup which is given to you, in which we can apply the Bernoulli's equation. And then once you write down the Bernoulli's equation, look at what all terms can be neglected or cancelled out. So it it is clear that your datum would be same. Your pressure 2 becomes 0. So you are only playing with P1, V1 and V2. Okay. So I hope you got this. Now let's move on to question number 3.